Hi, I'm Leslie Dominicki, and I'm a professional barrel racer and horse trainer. These two horses are my two barrel horses. I have been barrel racing for approximately 30 years. Barrel racing is a sport in rodeo, as well as other barrel racings across the country. Barrel racing has been around for approximately 60 years. It's a timed event. The fastest time wins. No holds barred.
Give us a webpage. How can people go out and support you and see?
You can go, as far as finding out more about rodeo and barrel racing, you can go onto the Women's Professional Rodeo Association webpage. You can go on the National Barrel Horse Association webpage, find out everything you need to know about barrel racing, who's out there, who's winning, who's not. It's a whole way of life going down the road with horses. It's a full-time job, and a lot of these girls, as well as myself, do it all the time, and it takes a lot of work and a lot of time and a lot of patience and a lot of money. How much money? Well, you can win a lot of money, but you also spend a lot of money. I mean, we all know what gas prices are to go down the road. Our entry fees, depending on the rodeos, the barrel races you go to, can be, you know, a couple hundred dollars, but then there's purses that can get up to $5,000 to $10,000. So you do have your expenses, but if you win it, you can make some money at it. But again, it's a full-time job, and you have to be very dedicated to going down the road with your horses. That's my 12-year-old barrel horse. This is her 3-year-old daughter. They're both, the 3-year-old will eventually become my next barrel horse. The other one has been running for approximately 3-4 years. It takes at least 8 years to train a barrel horse properly, where they're out competing and being able to win. So this 3-year-old here will be another 5 years before she's actually ready to win some money. So it takes a lot of time.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, it's your homeless Medusa, Abdul Shahid Munir. Listen, you know how we do it. City, state to state, community to community. Don't be surprised when you may see us in your community. Talk about community. Right now we're with Miss Leslie Dominicki.
Hi, how are you?
And where are we at?
We are on the Pennsylvania Turnpike on the western side of Pennsylvania.
Okay, and you're going?
I'm heading east to on the other side of Pennsylvania, but I'm coming from Colorado.
See, now we're gonna lie. We're gonna say we was in Colorado, but she was. All right, now talk about horses. All right. Now tell us a little bit about what you do.
Well, a barrel race is, there's 3 55-gallon drums set in the cloverleaf pattern.
Okay.
Fastest time wins. You make one right-hand turn, 2 left-hand turns, or 1 left-hand turn, 2 rights. And again, fastest time wins.
Now, I know y'all guys are a little confused about that, because some of y'all guys never seen barrel racing before. Y'all were like, what in the world, barrel racing? All right, well, what we're going to do, we're going to show a little bit of barrel racing. How difficult is it to do what you're doing?
It's very difficult. The competition is very hard. Okay. There's a lot of good horses, a lot of good barrel racers out there.
Okay.
A lot of your local communities have your local small barrel races or rodeos to go to, and it's a great family outing, and everybody should at least see one rodeo in their lifetime.
One. All right? I guarantee y'all see two.
Yeah.
All right? Now, if people want to do more about this rodeo, now economy's kind of bad and whatnot, if somebody wish to be part of this, do you suggest them to be part of this?
Oh, absolutely. And like I said, it's a great family thing to do together. There's all kind of organizations and associations that cater to young girls, young guys, whether you're doing other rodeo events for the men or the barrel racing for the women.
Right.
And you can go on the websites as far as the Women's Professional Rodeo Association or the Professional Cowboys Association and find out more about it and where they are in your area.
A lot of people talk about rodeo, and come on now, you gotta be in shape for to get on that. You know what I'm saying?
Well, again, yes, you do. I mean, these girls that ride their horses, they ride the horses every day. These horses are conditioned, and the girls also have to be very fit and very strong and very conditioned, as well as the guys.
Now you, come on now, we're talking about you now, all right? Later, but we're talking about you now. You compete now. How fit are you? I mean, come on now, it's kind of hard to get there.
A lot of times when I get done with my competition run, I'm usually breathing harder than the horse is.
Okay.
And as fit as I am, I'm still breathing hard.
All right, now tell us a little bit. You also train horses as well?
Yes, I do.
Difficult to train a horse?
difficult. It's just very time consuming. You start them when they're very young, as far as 2-year-olds, and then you start from there and you've got to go slow. These barrel horses aren't ready to run as far as competition horses until they're at least 8 years old.
Okay.
Now, the pig training a horse for a dog, which is hard.
Horses. Can't give a horse cookies. Horses don't take cookies and they don't understand like dogs do.
Listen, ladies and gentlemen, I know y'all enjoy yourself. Remember, y'all want to see more, always go to
Women's Professional Rodeo Association website, the WPRA, or the PRCA Pro Rodeo Association.
Listen, it's my pleasure of bringing y'all guys this. I'm very happy. Our first interview, and we're looking for many, many more. Hopefully, we'll catch you in Colorado or somewhere.
Maybe. All right. Maybe. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, this is your man, Abdul Shaheed. We're with
Leslie Dominicki.
And we're in your community.